The Nikola 56 project is motivated by astrophysical implications. In neutrino wind-driven core collapse supernovae, Nikola 56 is one of the most abundant seed nuclei, which would eventually build up heavy elements. At this moment, the astrophysical modeling does not reproduce the observations about this heavy element abundances. Therefore, we are still actively searching for the reasons or what we don't know yet about these scenarios.
So one of the main goals in nuclear astrophysics has been to understand how the elements that we observe around us were synthesized in the universe. And this is a multifaceted effort that requires observational astrophysics, actually looking out at the sky, and nuclear astrophysics modeling. And so that's what we can actually provide here in the laboratory setting, is actually studying the specific reactions of interest to provide the relevant nuclear data.
So this was one of those great projects to actually be involved with. It really makes you appreciate working in a national laboratory. There were so many aspects of this that were so interesting, and there were so many opportunities to learn more, and also to make a significant contribution to the field.
There are multiple experimental efforts to explore direct measurements on these Nikola 56 neutrino-induced reactions. However, Nikola 56 only exists with 6 days of half-life. This is a radioactive isotope, so there is no naturally available on the Earth.
One of the main reasons why the Lance facility in particular here at Los Alamos National Lab was a unique place to perform this measurement is really by capitalizing on the unique capabilities that exist here through collaboration with the isotope production facility for the target production and fabrication, and then within a pretty quick turnaround, being able to provide that target to us so that we can perform the measurement using the neutron beams that are available here.
The goal of chemistry in this project was to prepare a Nikola 56 target. The way we did this is by irradiating cobalt metal target in the isotope production facility, and then we took it to T48, and over there we have hot cells, so we can do remote handling manipulations of really hot targets. We're talking, you know, in the tens of curies. This project would not have been possible without the hot cells, because it would have been too much radiation to handle without remote techniques. Once we had the target ready, we were able to send it over for neutron capture cross-section measurements.
So I would say that the most difficult part of the measurement was actually in the few weeks leading up to the start, and as soon as the target comes to us, we need to be ready to hit the ground running, because every day that we waste is target sample that we're losing.
We realized that since this is such a short-lived isotope, we only had one shot at this, so we had to optimize the entire facility as a whole. We looked at the WNR facility and we said, what else do we need to do here? So we went through and actually upgraded the infrastructure. We built a facility-wide metrology network so that we could utilize modern cutting-edge survey instruments. This allowed us to upgrade the spallation target in the facility. Treating the facility in this holistic way like this, we were really able to optimize the entire experiment, make sure we could get the maximum neutron flux on target, put the neutrons where we want it, while actually reducing neutron-induced backgrounds in our experiment.
This is the only measurement done so far, and this is the only place you can produce the short-lived radioactive isotope, make a separation, and fabricate as a reaction sample, and perform the reaction study at LANS.
So of course the analysis is currently underway. For studying neutron-induced reactions on Nikola 56. The one thing that I think that we can clearly demonstrate already is that studying these types of reactions is within reach.
With this new directly measured nuclear data at LANS, we will nail down the theoretical models in astrophysical scenarios that would help answer the puzzles of how the heavy elements are produced in the universe.